After scraping Google Maps data in 2023 and the same in 2024, here is how to scrape Google Maps in 2025. In this video, you will learn how to get your CSV Excel file with names, ratings, reviews, websites, and phone numbers. By the way, did you know that no matter how big your request is, you cannot exceed 120 results because of Google limits? If you are interested in getting Google Maps data at scale, emails included, feel free to go to scrape.io. 100 leads free of charge with the link in the description. Hi, I'm Franek, and today we are scraping Google Maps. And here is a result you can expect. So as you can see, we have retrieved 120 results with the URL, the title, the rating, the reviews, the website, and the phone number. The question is, how can we do that? How can we scrape the data? Well, to do that, I've used a web scraping tool called Octoparse. It's a freemium web scraping tool, meaning you can use the free version, and we will use the free version for this tutorial anyway. You can find the link in the description. You just click and download, and you can download for Windows or Mac. Before we jump into the tutorial, let's try to determine what we have to do as a human being to gather the data. As my mom always told me, we have to learn our lesson before making the exercise. For web scraping, it's the same thing. I've picked up this URL, which shows me restaurants near Nashville, Tennessee, USA. And the way Google Maps is displayed is really specific. The data are only showed in the left part of the screen, and we don't have access to all the data directly. First, we have to scroll down to the bottom of the page, but we don't scroll down here. We scroll down here, only to that part. And we don't have to scroll down to the bottom of the page too fast, otherwise it will kind of block Google Maps. We have to do it one bit at a time. We wait, we do it again, we wait, we do it again, and so on and so on. And at the end, we will get 120 results, because I know for a fact that in reality, there are much more restaurants in Nashville. Another thing, I've tried to make things as simple as possible for you. So all the formulas, meaning the XPaths, that's the technical name, will be written in the description. So we have one formula for the scroll part, one formula for selecting all the data at once, and XPaths for the title, the ratings, the reviews, the website, and the phone number. Okay, these XPaths can change in the future, so we'll try to show you how to adjust this formula if needed. And to make things even easier, we will split our task into two groups. First, we will extract all the URLs at once, and then we'll insert the URLs to gather the data. Believe me, this way is much easier than doing everything at once. So let's begin by copy and paste our URL. As you can see, I have already done my task. I will delete it and start it from scratch. I go to the home tab, I paste my URL, and I click on start. We have to resolve the pop-up first. So I turn on the browse mode, which, as its name suggests, will help me to navigate as if I were on my browser. I click on accept all. Then I can turn on my browse mode once I have access to my establishments, to my list of establishments. The first thing we have to try out right away is our scroll process. Because as we have said, this part is really specific on Google Maps. So I add a step and I create a loop. This loop I'm going to rename it. It will be easier for my understanding. And I change the loop mode, change it from list of URLs to scroll page. And then as a scroll area, I have two options, default or partial. Default is a wall window, partial is a part of the window. So we have to wonder whether it's a partial scroll area or a default scroll area. I'll let you 2 seconds to think about it. No, I'm kidding, we don't have time. It's a partial scroll area because the scroll is only located on a part on our page. Partial. And then I have to insert my XPath. To be honest with you guys, this XPath is pretty hard to find on a first try. I had to try it out multiple times before finding the correct one. But to give you a glimpse of how I did it to find it out, I made a right click, inspect, and I end up with my HTML document. Then if I do Control F, I can write my XPath. And if I end up up with one result, it's likely to be the right one. We are going in the right direction, the right way. And here is the element located thanks to my XPath. And as you can see, it looks logical. This element encompasses the wall scrolling part. So we will try it out. I copy and paste my XPath. Then another choice to the bottom of the page, meaning like this, or for one screen, meaning like this, one bit at a time. There is no right answer, to be honest. It's just you try it out and you see what is working. I've made the test beforehand and what is working is for one screen. I end the loop when there is no more content to load. And as a waiting time, I might suggest to set 5 seconds waiting time, because if the waiting time is not high enough, there is a risk you will be blocked. Let me show you to make you understand how it's working. Okay, we scroll down really fast, really fast, really fast, again. And at some point, I will be blocked. See, I've scrolled down too fast and now I have to wait for a very long time before having access to the following data. So that's not what we want. We want something smooth. So 5 seconds is good. I go to the option, I add a 1 second timeout here as well. And I'm going to run my task to see if everything is working correctly. Before that, I can also rename my task. Let's call it Google Maps test URL. And then I run my task. We are not extracting any data for now, but that's okay. We just want to test whether our scrolling loop is working or not. So what I'm doing is that I click on Show Browser and I've forgotten to accept the cookies. So let's do that right away. I have clicked on Go to Web Page. I jump to the option use cookie from the current page, and I click on Apply. See, even I am doing mistakes after years of experience. So if you do mistakes on your own, don't panic. It's perfectly normal. What's more important is to identify where does your mistake come from. So Show Browser, do I have my pop-up this time? No, I don't have it. And it seems to me that the scrolling process is working just fine. See, I'm not touching anything. And every 5 seconds, there is one scroll. So it looks good to me. I can stop my task and let's move on. So I will scroll down to the bottom of the page until the end, and I will extract all my URLs at once. So I create another loop. Let's keep it as loop item, and I change the loop mode to variable list. And same thing as before, I have to write a matching XPath. As the XPath is that one, at least for the time being. Let me explain what that means. I identify an A element. An A element within the HTML document always identifies a URL. So if your XPath doesn't start by /A, it's not gonna work. Then it contains href. Basically, href also identifies a URL, and it identifies a URL containing /maps/place. So if I come back to Google Maps and I copy and paste my XPath, you can see that I've got 72 elements. And if I show the next results, each time I have access to another item. So this is the correct XPath, right? And indeed, each time we have an A element with an href attribute containing /maps/place, everything is all right. And if I check it out one more time, my loop item, for now there are only 3 items, but that's because we haven't scrolled down to the bottom of the page yet. Let's add another second wait before action. And now we extract the URLs. How do I do that? Well, I add another step, and this time I add an extract data step. I make sure that extract data in the loop is checked. And now we'll focus on this part, on the data preview part. I click on Add Custom Field, capture data on the page, and we will extract the URL. I don't have to write an XPath right now. It's not necessary, but what's important nonetheless is to check relative XPath to the loop item. If I click on Confirm, nothing is shown. Damn, have we made a mistake? No, everything has gone according to the plan. And if I click on More, Customize Fields, and select URL, boom, I have access to my URL. Magic. I think we are good to go now. I will click and run standard mode. If everything works as expected, we should end up with 120 URLs. If not, that's all right. We will adjust our workflow, we will adjust our task accordingly. And we have got a total of 121 lines. We are lucky, we've got one extra line. Yoo-hoo. All that remains to do is to export the data, we remove the duplicates, there is only one of them, and as an Excel file, that shall do. Once it's exported, we just let it aside for the moment, and we'll create our second task, meaning our task to extract the data from these URLs. This is what I've done with the task entitled Google Maps card. I will delete it and create it from scratch. We click on New, Custom task. And this time we have to insert multiple URLs at once. So I import from file, I select my Excel file, I select my colon, and I have access to my 121 valid URLs. We have our pop-up, we know what we should do, and we don't forget to use the cookies. Only one thing remaining, we add an extract data step. We wait before action, let's say 3 or 4 seconds, and we add our columns, meaning the title, the rating, the review, the website, and the phone number. Before that, let's add what we can call a confirmation data. For example, I can add the page URL. So to add the title, I capture data on the page, I type title, and I copy and paste my XPath, which is //h1. I confirm, and something that I like to do is to click on the more, clean data, add step, and I trim spaces from the start and from the end. In that case, it seems it makes no difference, but sometimes it does, and believe me, it makes your result much more professional. I confirm and I apply. Let's repeat the same process for the rating. This time it's a bit different, you will see. Rating, confirm, and what do we have? We have nothing. And this is the same thing as we have done for the URL. It means we are selecting the stars, but by default, Octoparse is extracting a text, so obviously there is no text related to the stars. So let's take a look at the HTML code to have a better understanding of what we are talking about. I'm going to pick up a specific URL, let's say that one, and I will paste my XPath. Control F, my XPath, and we are selecting that element. Span, class, something, role, image, area label, 4.1 stars. So that's interesting, isn't it? We have access to the number of stars within the HTML code. So what we have to do is to extract the content, the value inside the attribute area label. So let's do that. I come back to Octoparse, I click on more, customize fields, select other attributes, and area label, you got it, and 4.5 stars. What's next? The number of reviews. Add custom field, capture data on the page, and reviews. 282. This time we have access to a text, but I can do things differently if I want to. Because same thing as before, we have access to the text 73 reviews within the area label attribute. So I can do that. Or I can do customize fields, select other attributes, and area label. It works too. My opinion is that no matter what you are doing, as long as it's working, it's all right. The website, this time confirm. Same thing as before. We have to click on more, and this time select URL, I think. Yes, right. And let's finish by the phone number. Phone number. Space character are not accepted by Octoparse, so this is not working, but this is working. I click on confirm. We understand what the phone number is, but it's not really elegantly written. So let's see what it is linked with. It's equal to 0. Oh, because there is no phone number in that example. So let's pick up another random example, it doesn't matter. And we select that element. So what I can do, and again, it is just an idea, you can do things your way. What I can do is to extract the content from the area label attribute, one more time, and we will remove the phone parts. So, more, customize field, select over attributes, area label, and I click on more, clean data, and I replace, meaning I remove the phone part. And voila, my phone number is cleaned. Let's rename our task Google Maps test card. And I click on run, standard mode, and I see you back once I've got my results. It is a success, bravo. All that remains to do is to export your lines into an Excel file. And here is what it should look like. This is the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If it's the case, you can subscribe. And if you want to scrape Google Maps data at scale, you can visit scrape.io. Remember, with the link in the description, you can get your first 100 leads free of charge. There is nothing else to see, the end.